Are there any more questions in the middle lane? Please.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Prabhakaran. I'm working as a supervisor. Firstly, I would like to know, there is a common saying in most of the religions that whoever follows God's sayings religiously will go to heaven, and if not, will go to hell. Taking this into consideration, I would like to know what will be the status of non-Muslims on the day of judgment. Secondly, I would like to know the importance of the holy month of Ramadan for the benefit of non-Muslims who have come here. And finally, I would like to say, from the little experience I have gained in my life, I can strongly say Islam is the only religion which has clear-cut, sound theoretical knowledge supported with logical examples with reasoning.
The brothers asked three questions or three statements he had made. The first question was that all the religions say that if you don't believe in the commandments of God, you will go to hell. What will happen to non-Muslim on the day of judgment? Brother, as I mentioned earlier, the Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 48 and Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 116, Allah, if He pleases, He may forgive any sin, but the sin of shirk, associating partners with God, He'll never forgive. So if a person dies as a non-Muslim and he associates partners with others, he believes in false gods, he does idol worship, he shall never go to heaven. Compulsory, he'll go to hell. To go to heaven, you have to believe in one God, worship Him alone, and follow His commandments. Regarding a second question, what is the benefit of the month of Ramadan to the non-Muslims? Quran says in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 83, fasting has been prescribed to you as it was prescribed to people who came before you so that you may learn self-restraint. The reason we fast is because we increase our taqwa, our God consciousness, our piety. And Surah Baqarah chapter number 2 verse 185 says, Ramadan was the month in which the Quran was revealed as a guidance to the whole of humanity, as a criteria to judge right from wrong. Ramadan is this month in which the glorious Quran, the last and final revelation, was revealed to the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And the Quran says, this Quran is a guidance for humanity, not only for Muslims or for the Arabs, for the whole of humanity. And it is a criteria to judge right from wrong. So this month of Ramadan, how does it benefit the non-Muslims? Quran was revealed in it as a guidance for whole of humanity, Muslims and non-Muslims. Furthermore, beloved Prophet Muhammad said, Ramadan is the month in which the Satans, they are imprisoned. The gates of heaven are open and the gates of hell are closed. That means there are more chances you'll do good deeds. A person does more good deeds in Ramadan, the chances of him doing bad deeds is less. As far as non-Muslims, the message of Islam may go very well in the hearts of the non-Muslims because the devil, the Satan, the imprisonment. So more chances of the non-Muslims accepting Islam, more chances he'll come closer to Islam. Regarding a third statement, you believe that Islam has got theoretical points in it and it is backed up with reason and logic. So when you agree that Islam then rules and regulations which are backed up with reason and logic, my question to you in this month of Ramadan, then why don't you accept Islam?
It is not a question of accepting Islam. For the matter of fact, I do accept all the religions, all the good things every religion is saying. So I don't have any...
Brother, you say you believe in all the good things in all the religions. That means there are some bad things in some religions, correct?
I do agree. Strongly agree.
Oh, fine. I want to ask you a simple question. What do you think is bad in Islam?
Practically, I have not come across anything bad in Islam, but maybe in practice, people have...
No, in Islam, don't talk about Muslim. Muslim may be bad. I'm not talking about Muslims.
Okay.
Talk about Islam. There are Muslims who may have alcohol, there are Muslims who may cheat.
I have not come across anything
very,
bad about Islam,
very good.
To be
now,
very frank.
Now, you told me very frankly, you take good things of all the religions. You also said you know there are bad things in other religions. And you also said you don't know of anything bad in Islam. So
yeah,
now in the other religions, there are good and bad. In this religion, only good. Suppose I give you two glasses of water. One is pure water, other water, pure water, and one drop of urine. So which water will you drink?
Good water, of course.
Good, pure water. So this is a pure religion. Absolutely pure, without adulteration. Now, when I realize it is pure, when you are thirsty, you will drink the pure water. No, I believe it is pure, but I won't drink it. It doesn't make sense. If I want to get admission in a university, I do my survey. This university is the best. Why don't you take admission? No, I'll think about it. If you don't have the money to pay your fees, fine. University is very good, but too expensive. I can't afford the fees. Islam is free. If you agree it's the best, you have to accept it. Or maybe it's a hypocrisy. See, if I agree it's the best, I have to accept it. If you know there are no faults, that means God will question you on the day of judgment. If you agree, God gave you the message in your heart, it is the best religion, why don't you accept it? See, if you agree it's the best, it's illogical. It's illogical not to accept it. If you think there's something bad, I will clarify your misconception now. If you agree it's the best religion, if you agree it's the most logical, unless you are illogical. If you are logical, you have to agree the most logical religion. Unless you consider yourself to be illogical, brother. You know, sometimes, brother, emotions. What will my mother say? What will my father say? What will society say? Muslim! So these things may prevent you from accepting. I agree. It's difficult. It's not easy, brother. But if you are logical, if you are scientific, you have to accept what is best. Therefore, I say, if someone proves to me any religion better than Islam, I will accept it. If someone proves to me today, anytime, there's any religion better than Islam, I am ready to accept. If someone proves to me Christianity is better, I am ready to accept Christianity. Someone proves to me Hinduism is better, I am ready to accept Hinduism. I am not just talking. I have discussions with the doctors of divinity, with the top Christians. I'm not a scholar, I'm a student. I consider myself to be a student of comparative religion. But I have dialogues and discussions and debates with the top scholars of Hinduism. You know, the most popular Hindu speaker is Shri Ravi Shankar. Have you heard of him?
Very much.
Yes, he agreed with the Quran.
I'm a big fan of him, in fact.
You're a fan of him, mashallah. Have you seen my debate with Shri Ravi Shankar?
No, I've not seen.
So you should see the debate with your hero.
Yeah.
Shri Ravi Shankar, sure. And the student of comparative religion.
Inshallah, if I get an opportunity, definitely.
Yes, and since you agree, even he agreed that God has got no images. He agreed in the truthfulness of the Quran. Unfortunately, he didn't accept it. You know why? If he accepts, he will lose all the following.
I agree.
You agree. Do you have a following? Do you have a following, brother?
No, I don't have any following.
Very good. So what will you lose? Maybe some friendship. Maybe some relatives. It's difficult. It's difficult. But if you know the truth, you should accept it. There's nothing wrong about it.
Actually, so far as of now, I have not thought of about this because this is the very toughest and hardest thing in life to make.
Think today in the month of Ramadan. You ask me, how does it benefit non-Muslims? It benefits a non-Muslim in opening the heart towards the truth. So I request you to think it over. If not today, yet you have another 3 weeks. Another 2-3 weeks you have till the month of Ramadan. If not today, except in the month of Ramadan, it will benefit you. And inshallah, inshallah, I can tell you that inshallah, if you accept Islam, all your previous sins will be forgiven. 100%. So today, if you accept Islam, if suppose you die today, I can tell for sure, you will go to Jannah. I'm not sure about myself, but about yourself, I can tell you. Because the moment a person accepts Islam, all his previous sins are forgiven. If you accept Islam and if something happens to you today, I don't know about others. Inshallah, you'll go to Jannah.
Thank you very much.
So I'm waiting for your acceptance, brother.